Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the SyncFusion React pivot table using the Create React App command. I will also show you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding data and adding rows, columns, and values. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I create the app, using the Create React App toolchain in VS Code as the editor, and then I show the output in the Chrome browser. I create a new application in the command prompt, using the npx create react app command, and provide the app name, MyReactApp. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Next, I navigate to the desired location, and run this example, using the npm start command. Now, I can edit the app.tsx page to show the pivot table component. Next, I open the project in VS Code and remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file. I remove the styles from the app.css file and import the Bootstrap 5 theme styles to apply them to the pivot table. Then, I install the package using the command npm install at SyncFusion EJ2 React Pivot View. To start using the pivot table component, I import it from the EJ2 React Pivot View package and include the Pivot View component tag. Let me run this application. See, the pivot table component is rendered and no records are displayed. Data can be bound to the pivot table using the data source property in data source settings. I add data.js file. Include the pivot data object with fields like year, quarter, country, and products, etc. I import this object in the app.tsx page and assign it to the data source property. In data source settings, there are four major axes: rows, columns, values, and filters. First, I will show you how to map values to a pivot table. I include the values collection and add the name property. I map the data source field sold to this name property. I also add another name property in this collection and map the amount field. See now, the pivot table shows the total sum of units sold and the total sum of sold amount. Here I can split up the units sold based on country. To do that, I add the rows collection and map the field country using the name property. Check now in the pivot table rows are rendered based on country. To display rows with hierarchy, I map another field called products in rows collection using the name property. See here, the pivot table rows are displayed with expand icons. When the countries are expanded, we can view the sold units and amount for individual products. To map fields in the column axis, I add column settings and map the field year using the name property. Looking at pivot table, years are displayed as column headers. To display sub-column headers, I map another field called quarter using the name property in columns collection. See now, when I expand the year column header, quarters are displayed. I can also set a custom header using the caption property. In values collection, I add the caption as units sold for the first field and sold amount for the second field. I set the height of the pivot table to 300 and the width to 100%. See, the provided caption is displayed for the values. Finally, I will show you how to use the filter axis. You can filter data bound in rows, columns, and values using the filters property. Here, I want to filter based on the field quarter. I will remove the quarter from the column axis and use it in the filter axis. To view a filter axis in the UI, we need either to enable the grouping bar or to show the field list. Here, I'm going to show the field list. With the help of the field list, we can view the row, column, value, and filter axes. Import the module field list from the Pivot View package and inject it into the Pivot services. Then, enable the property Show Field List. Check the output. You can find the symbol at the top left corner of the pivot table to open field list pop-up. When I click that, the list of fields will be displayed. You will also find the filters, columns, rows and values axes. I click the filter icon and choose the quarters from the filter axis. The Q1 and Q2 quarters are removed from the total sum. Here, the units sold for France without Q1 and Q2 is 327. Without filtering, the units sold for France is 729. Now, let's see how to show the calculated field. To do that, I will import the calculated field module from the Pivot View package and inject its services. Then, I enable the Allow Calculated Field property. I use the Calculated Field Settings property to specify the fields and formula. Assign the field name as Total and formula as Total of Units Sold and its amount. Lastly, I need to add this field name Total to the Values collection using Name property. Then, add the caption as Total Units and the type as Calculated Field. Check now, the field, Total Units, is displayed in the value axis. In this video, I showed you how to configure the Sync Fusion React pivot table using the Create React App command and how to configure a few of the control's basic features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.